belong to the Italian Sports Club in Werribee. How are you all? Oh, we're going to have to do that again. We're going to have to do that again. We need to. You've got to give us a little bit more than that. We've got four champions out the back from both representative clubs. They want to hear you. Good evening and welcome along to the Italian Sports Club in Werribee. How are you? Yeah! All right. Fantastic. Great to have you all here. Thanks for coming along. Let's get on with the show without too much further ado. These are called That's Good for Footy panel shows. We call them That's Good for Footy because we want to try and put the fun back into football. And the way that we do that is we get the players to come along where you get to meet them. So it's where the fans meet the players and the players meet the fans. Let's get on with the show and get these boys out here and have some fun with them. Let's go with it. Please welcome to the show from the Essendon Football Club, our first panellist. He has played a total of 71 games and kicked 106 goals. When he plays for the Essendon Football Club, he wears the number 13 on his back. Please welcome to the stage, Orazio Fantasia. Hey, fans. Feeling well?
I'm feeling at home here in the Italian club.
Yeah, good. You all realise that is Orazio Fantasia, don't you? Yeah, good. Yeah, you love the hair, good. That's what we wanted to hear. He's not so keen on it anymore, I don't think. I like it too, though, mate.
Thank you.
You'll make the decision what's right for you.
Yeah, we'll cut it off soon.
Yeah, all right. Let's get our second panellist up here. He's played a total of 176 games and kicked a total of 108 goals. When he plays for the Essendon Football Club, he wears the number 18 on his back. Please welcome to the stage, Michael Hurley. Isn't it nice to see him back? You see, he's had a little bit of an injury there, which we'll discuss with him a little bit later when we get the chance, but nice to see his smiling face up on the panel. You'll agree, Essendon fans? Yes. Collingwood fans are going, I don't give a stuff, but anyway, let's get on with the show. Please welcome to the show from the Collingwood Football Club. You ready for this? Our third panellist, he's played a total of 126 games and kicked a total of 46 goals. When he plays for the Collingwood Football Club, he wears the number 13 on his back. Please welcome to the stage, Taylor Adams.
Good old Collingwood forever. How's it? They know how to play the
Taylor,
game.
How are you, mate?
Very well, thank you.
Excellent. Nice to see you, my friend. Yeah, great to have you back on the show, and nice to have you know, here representing the Collingwood Football Club and clan of these Collingwood football fans.
Love it.
Something along those lines. Let's go for our last one. Here, please welcome to the stage our fourth panellist. He has played a total of 157 games and kicked 95 goals. When he plays for the Collingwood Football Club, he wears the number 7 on his back. Could you please welcome to the stage Adam Treloar? I want to test you.
Good old Collingwood forever. They know how to play the game.
That's Treloar. There you go.
Yeah, mate.
Good, mate. Very, very well indeed. Ladies and gentlemen, could you please put your hands together as a collective group for our four panellists that are here this evening, gracing us with their presence. I wanted to say to you boys, evening, gents, and welcome to the show. This show is going to be divided into two parts tonight. We're going to have a little bit of footy talk off the top. We'll be serious just for the first little while, and then we'll get into some fun and games a little bit later on. So we're going to dedicate this first part with a little bit of football talk. How are you feeling at the moment? Give us your opinion on how the season has gone from both clubs' perspective, your perspective from your club. How do you think the season's gone thus far? Give us a little bit of a breakdown. Whoever wants to speak from the Collingwood Football Club first.
Well, we've probably gone, both clubs have probably done the opposite. We started really strong and we've obviously had a few injuries and tapered off a little bit towards the back half of this year. And the boys next to us have done the opposite. They've won 5 in a row.
Yeah, 5 in a row.
5 in a row. And look like they're going to certainly play finals now. So, we've got some work to do to cement our spot in the eight. But, yeah, got a couple of winnable games coming up and looking forward to it.
Yeah. What about you, Ads? How have you assessed the season thus far from the Collingwood Football Club perspective? I know injuries is going to play a big part. We'll go through a little bit of that. But what's your opinion on where things are at?
Yeah, I think Tay nailed it on the head, really. Yeah. We started really well. Injuries have hurt us, no doubt. But we've got to find consistency in our performance. We've sort of tapered back a bit, haven't really played consistently enough the way we'd like to play. I think our starts have been poor the last couple of weeks. We've started really slowly. So we've really kicked, not even kicked us out. They've probably kicked us out of the game within, by quarter time the last 2 weeks. I mean, the Giants are up by 10 goals and Richmond are up by 6 or 7 goals at quarter time. So they've probably been the most disappointing things. But in saying that, in both games, we fought on, we fought hard. One thing I do know about the guys is we love and care for each other, and the care that we have for each other far outweighs anything else. So we're motivated to keep going well. We're motivated to play consistent footy. Like Tay said, we've got a couple winnable games coming up, but that starts with hard work. So we're looking forward to the game this week.
Good. Oh, excellent. I love that.
A good response. Yeah,
yeah, well good. Said. Yeah, well, very well said. Even the Essendon boys going, that's not bad. Can I steal some of that? It is your chance, because I do want to hear, how do you find the season thus far? Give yourself a little bit of a pass mark, a rating. As alluded to, started off a little bit slow and now things are progressing for you. How have you seen the season thus far? How's it panned out?
Yeah, pretty much, yeah, bang on. Obviously slow out of the gates. I think, I'm not sure what we were, 4-6, I think, for the first half of the season, which is obviously not where we wanted to be. I think element of that was a new defensive system.
Yep.
We got Ben Rutten over from Richmond, who's been fantastic for us, but only having the one pre-season, learning our new game plan and things like that, was always going to take a little bit of time to sort of gel. I think that we're seeing the rewards of that at the moment.
It's a really good point that you make. I know I spoke with Devin Smith, one, he was on the show earlier on in the year, but he also alluded to the fact it was just a case of everyone gelling together, getting used to the new structures and finding out what was going to work, what wasn't, and no point throwing the baby out with the bathwater. Let's see what we need to do in order to get better. How have you seen it, Rez?
Yeah, I think Hurl's hit the nail on the head as well, but I think also our forward line is now starting to play a bit more consistent footy. And having a bit of continuity, actually having the same sort of guys playing each week, which we sort of haven't had throughout the whole year. Joey's been injured, James Short's been injured, myself included. So we've had only really Waller that's played every game.
Yeah.
So, it makes it tough.
Continuity is a big word. It gets used a lot in football. And I think every club goes through it, especially when you get a lot of new recruits in and you've got the younger braid mixing in with the older guys. But it's been interesting to see how it's all developing. Now it gets to the pointy end of the season. We start to move into August, September. I'll give you a couple of topics that I wanted to allude to. The season's been, I don't know how the fans feel about it, but it's been probably a little bit weird. AFL changing the rules, you've got the school review system, you've got coaches being sacked, there's rule changes. For players, I know that you always say within the four walls, it stays, whatever happens within the club stays within the club, but all these other things are happening. Do they have an effect on you? You know, like when you've got injuries, you've got rule changes, you've got score reviews, you've got the AFL saying, shh, everyone, don't make a noise while you watch the football. Do all those sort of things affect you as footballers? Is there an opinion that you have on that? Anyone that wants to jump in here with a...
Well, the score review pisses me off because they
they've got it wrong a lot. It would have pissed you boys off from the weekend.
Yeah. Zaka was upset about that.
Yeah, and that's my point from the most recent, from the weekend, David Zaharakis' goal, and obviously being disallowed, and they didn't even review it. So does that affect you as players? You want to go out there and you're playing football, I get it, but there are a lot of external things happening within the football landscape nowadays more than probably they used to. So give us a little bit of insight.
Go on. I guess it would vary from player to player and, I guess, coach to coach. I know for me, I don't really watch the TV shows, I don't really listen to the radio or things like that. Sort of stuff sort of goes on away from the game for me. But then I'm sure there's certain guys that are into that, watch the shows and listen to the radio and hear all the sort of talk about it and the fans and the clubs talk about what goes on inside the game. So it depends on the individual, I think, to an extent. Yep. But you touched on injuries there. That's a thing that every club has to deal with. These guys have been unfortunate. They've copped at some really good players and consistently throughout the year, which makes it tough.
Yeah.
We're only starting to sort of see that at the moment with sort of Hep and, well, I've lost Joe and Dev as well, which are important players. But there's different elements you sort of have to deal with,
Yeah, it's been really interesting. You look at Richmond Football Club, Melbourne Football Club, expectations that were put on them at the start of the year. They've come out and they've just been, sorry, I did a show with Dacos, Shaw and David Rees-Jones on last Friday, those boys don't hold back. I mean, they were pretty forthright in their assessment of where they think Melbourne's season in. I think the word shit came to mind. but you look at other clubs that have been through a lot this year. Richmond, for example, they're now starting to come back to full strength. Alex Rance, if he comes back in and they make finals, you know, wow, what an opportunity that'll be. But I was obviously very curious because you see a lot of the media and the armchair experts that come out, they're jumping all over injuries this year and why are we having them. A lot of soft tissue injuries, hamstring injuries, those sort of things. You last year, how unfortunate was that? I've never heard of anyone going down, excuse me, two hamstrings in one go.
Yeah, it wasn't ideal, mate.
Wow.
yeah, no, I did both my hams at the same time. So, but in terms of the soft tissue injuries, I think the game's so demanding now. The expectation to perform, the expectation to run offensively, defensively is demanding more than what it ever has been.
Yep.
I know the sports science side of things, they're still trying to find the best ways to get the athletes up, to get them at their peak fitness, to get them to play at their peak fitness come game day. So the injuries are always going to be a part of it. But there's a lot of the times the injuries, the freak injuries that happen that you can't control, but then there's the injuries that the soft tissue ones that you talk about. That's more on the sports science guys, so blame them. Don't blame the players.
Yeah. Nice to actually say, hey, it was you, not me.
People say it a lot, and it is true, though, the pre-season you can do. So the more pre-season, the more training you do, then sort of set you up for the whole year. So if you can keep backing them up year after year, your body gets stronger and more durable.
It's really interesting you actually bring up that point, because I would have alluded to that with Collingwood, just knowing that you boys played in the finals last year, and then you come back, you've got a shortened pre-season, but you've got to come in and you've still got the same workload, and then you've got to come in and play like everybody else does when the season starts. Having a shorter season, any method to any madness that's associated with having a shorter season?
I think the best thing about us, and I'm Tager probably vouch for the same thing, it was actually really refreshing to come back and not have to, you know, bust our balls from the start of November to December, have a break, and then do it again. We pretty much got all the way up until Christmas off, pretty much for the older guys, and then after that, that's when we could focus on the season. I'm a massive advocate for shortening the pre-season because I hate all the running and the hot weather and the 2Ks and all that garbage crap that we got to do. Because I think it's about training smarter. It's not necessarily about how many Ks we're running, how we're doing it. It's about the efficiency of the running, how we're training, getting that balance with our weights program, with the Pilates, everything that we do. So I think it's about the smartness and how we approach the preseason, not necessarily about how far we're running.
Wow, that's great insight. Thank you very much for sharing that with me. What I wanted to just do, I'm just going to read them all out. We're not going to go into anything here, but this is a long list. This is Collingwood short term: James H, Dane Beams, Jordan Ngoi, Levi Greenwood, Darcy Moore, Isaac Quaynor, Ben Reed, Jordan Roughhead. Tell me to stop whenever you want. Brandon Sear, Daniel Wells, Tom Phillips, Jaden Stevenson, Will Kelly, Nathan Murphy, Sam Murray, John Noble, Taylor Adams. I used that name last because I wanted to allude to it, but that's a long injury list, even though it is short term. But a lot of them are injuries that we spoke of that could be soft tissue. That's a lot of things going on down
there.
There's
suspensions in there too.
Yeah, right, of course, yeah. But in saying that, you've only got two long term, which is not too bad when you look at, you know, the longevity of what's going on with clubs at the moment. Lyndon Dunn and Tom Langdon, obviously both knees with those boys. Beamer's back at the club, going to play a couple of games in the VFL. Is that right?
Yeah, well, he was back in the club on Monday for the first time in 3 weeks.
Good on him.
Yeah, I'm sure he'll share when he's ready about what he's been up to in the last couple of weeks. And I'm not too sure if he's going to play VFL or when. I know he's going to play footy at some stage this year, but... Yep. It's unknown to us as to when he's going to be back.
Yeah. Just reading out that list, boys, and I know we talked about it with soft tissue injuries, is there anything else that is going on because of that? Because that seems to be a lot more than most other clubs are going through at the moment, and I've seen it's pretty well documented out there in the media landscape as to how much everyone's trying to come up with reasons as to why Collingwood's got that many injuries. Is there anything you can allude to, or is it just that's just the nature of the beast and it's football?
Well, it really is. It really is. I mean, the prep, the rehab, the everything that goes behind these players doing their soft tissue injury. So guys like Ben Reed and Darcy Moore who have been prone to hurting themselves, what they do behind the scenes is incredible. They get their bodies up week in, week out to play, and it's what you said, it's just unlucky. It's just really unlucky. The program we have at the footy club is first class. It's, you know, I've been in the system now eight, nine years, and it's the last 2 years have been the most enjoyable, the best run program that I've been a part of in terms of the, in terms of the footy program side.
Okay.
But you do speak of the injuries, and it was a bit of a mantra we took with last year, even this year, is it doesn't matter the names really that are playing. It's about the roles and expectations that we expect of them players on game day to perform. I mean, you look at last year, we were fortunate enough to make the grand final, and fingers crossed we can do it again this year. We got no doubt we can. We had players come in who, well, we had guys who aren't even on the list anymore. Guys like Adam Oxley came and played last year. He's not even on the list anymore, and he played and performed really well in a role that we expected him to play. And it's the same that we want to go this year. So it doesn't really matter who's out there as long as they're playing what we expected them to play. Yeah. And I'm sure that goes for not only us, but it'd be the exact same for the Bombers too.
Seriously, it's so good to get the insight from you guys. And I did write down there, is it just bad timing or coincidence? So it is a mixture of the two. Is there any truth to maybe thinking that since Jaden went out, just because of that little mishap, we won't go into it, but anyway, he went in, that the forward line structure has been, it's changed, and the scoring is not quite as prevalent as it has been. Your scores have been at somewhere around the 60 to 80 mark. Prior to that, you were looking at scores at over 100. Is there any feeling around that?
No doubt we miss him.
Yep.
He's a tough matchup for any back line. Got that speed, and he's sort of that medium-sized forward that can actually mark the ball over his head. So we certainly miss him, and he's, you know, the forward pressure he puts on is really valuable for us. But I don't think that's the whole and solely the reason why we haven't been able to kick big scores. There've been a few breakdowns in defence and just our ability to move the ball freely. So there's things we're working on, but looking forward to having him back. He's a very good player.
Absolutely. Well said. The Bombers, let's move over to you boys. You boys can relax now, drink more water and take the heat off you. The Bombers have had their fair share of injuries as well, and I just wanted to go into those. Short-term, Tom Bell, Chambers, Zach Clark, Dyson Heppel, Jaden Laverde, James Stewart, Orazio Fantasia, Michael Hurley. We'll talk about you two. Michael, how's everything going with you first, with the shoulder?
Yeah, going really well, actually. Yep. So I had shoulder surgery 2 weeks ago, touch over 2 weeks ago. Unfortunately, I could hit to the AC and sort of displaced that, so I had to go under the knife and strap it back down. But it's actually going really well. I've had shoulder surgery on the other side, which took somewhere like 3 months to recover, and this one's looking like I'll be back in another 2 or 3 weeks. So.
Oh, that's good. That's really good. Well done. That's nice recovery. And how are you feeling going through the recovery at the moment? Is like your head's in the right space? Can't wait to get back and playing football?
Yeah, I think the fact that the boys are going so well and that carrot of finals footy in a month or so is something that I'm really looking forward to, if we can make it, obviously. Having played for, I think it's my 11th season now, I've only played 2 or 3 finals and we've been shit out. So for another opportunity to get there in the part of the season that you really want to be playing, something that I'm really excited about.
Good on you, mate. I love hearing that. That's wonderful. And Orazio, I know that you've had a couple of problems. You're most likely going to go in for surgery at the end of the season.
Yep.
Is that the diagnosis at this stage?
Yeah.
Give us a little bit as to what's going on there.
I've got a little bit of a hip problem. Okay. So a little bit of a label tear on the hip that I'll fix up at the end of the year, but nothing you can't sort of grit your teeth and get through.
Yeah,
I'm going to have a run around on the weekend.
Excellent. Good. Wish you the best. I wish all of you the very best. And the reason I also bring up that I wish you the very best, it's just been announced today, round 23. Collingwood playing Essendon. Wow. If you want to say anything now, boys, get it off your chest before you get out the ground. Now, that should be a really interesting game. Friday night, I think it's been announced as happening. There you go. A bit of the good, the bad and the ugly. I reckon you're all bloody good up here. So, but that should be a really interesting game and see how things pan out. Obviously, you've got another 5 games before you even get to that. 4 games, yeah. So, you know, good luck to all of you. Thanks for sharing and how things are progressing for each of you at the club, and thanks for sharing a little bit of insight at the club as well. Please put your hands together for the boys, ladies and gentlemen. Thank you. What I want to do with you now, boys, is we'll still talk a little bit of football, but we'll get out of this nice and quickly. We're going to talk about the tips for this round coming up. And what I'll do is I actually give you the game, and then you guys can just tell me who you think and maybe a winning margin, and we'll go through it nice and quick. These games are proudly brought to you by the Big Picture people, the experts in home cinema. Let's get the big picture on these games. It is round 20 coming up Friday, August the 2nd. It's North Melbourne versus Hawthorn. Let's hear North Melbourne. That'll do. Let's go straight to Hawthorn. That'll do there. All right. This game, 7:50pm at Marvel Stadium, guys. What do you think here? We'll just go round. We'll go from left to right if you're happy with that.
Yeah, I think North will win.
North will win. And margin?
Ooh, 4 goals.
Oh, yeah. Okay, all right.
I reckon Hawthorn by 12 points.
Okay, all right.
Yeah, I like North too by 15.
Wow.
Yeah.
I like North, but not by that much, 8.
Excellent. All right. Okay. Let's go to this game then. Saturday, August the 3rd, 1:45pm at Marvel Stadium. Essendon versus Port Adelaide. Let's hear the Essendon song. We'll give them a little bit of that. This, you can join in here.
On the sky, up, up, to win the premiership flag. Our boys who play this grand old game are always striving for glory and fame. See the bombers fly up, up. We are the teams they don't fear. They all try their best, but they can't get near as the bombers fly.
There you go. Well done. Thank you very much. They came up against Port Adelaide. Let's hear their song. That'll do. All right. Let's go over to this end, boys. Essendon versus Port Adelaide. Your thoughts, tips, and a margin.
Port. No, I'm joking. I actually think the Bombers. Bombers.
Okay.
I think Port are hit and miss. So away from Melbourne, away from Adelaide, I think they hit and miss. So I reckon Bombers will get a hold of them, to be honest. Maybe good. 6 goals.
Yeah, wow. Okay, wow.
I reckon Bombers by 4 goals.
All right. Excellent. Yeah. Well, obviously, we know. We don't really need to say any more than that, do we? We'll just leave it at that. But you do play Marvel Stadium really well, and it is a great ground. I reckon you'll get a good crowd down there expected for that one as well. And I hope you get out there and smash Port Adelaide, because we hate the interstate teams. let's have a go at this. This game, 2:10pm at Giant Stadium. It's GWS versus Sydney. Let's hear GWS. Thanks, mate. Straight into Sydney. That'll do there. All right, what do you think here, boys? What do they call it? The Battle of the Bridge or something? Or something to do with the harbour? Or Who Cares Cup?
We played a few of those, didn't we?
Yeah.
We had about 10,000 people there.
Yeah.
What do you think? Margin of 1,500 between 4 games.
Wow. What do you think? Who's gonna smash who?
Oh,
Giants win, I think.
I really don't care. Probably, I think the Giants.
Yeah. Yeah, okay, yeah, I think we'll just go with that. Yeah, all right. Yeah. What do you think, boys?
Yeah, I think Giants comfortable.
Giants. Too. All right, move along. Let's get over to this one, Optus Stadium, 2:35pm. Yeah. Fremantle versus Geelong. Let's hear Freo. Thanks, mate. Straight into Geelong.
We are Geelong.
All right, that'll do. Fremantle versus Geelong at Optus over in Perth. You boys have all played on that deck, haven't you? You find it. Yep. What's it really like from a player's perspective? Is it as hard as everyone keeps talking about? Is it a difficult ground or...?
Yeah, it's hard.
Yep.
It is definitely hard on the foot.
Okay.
And quite slippery as well.
Yeah, right.
If you play a night game, so it's a little bit difficult to play on.
Yeah, cool. All right, what do you think here, chips-wise then? Fremantle versus Geelong?
Geelong.
Yeah?
Geelong.
Geelong?
I think Geelong. Geelong win.
Geelong. Yeah, Geelong.
Yeah, I think Freo will show up. Big week. Coach is confident. I reckon they might go close, but I think Cats just.
Okay, all right.
I think Cats by 10 goals.
Cats by 10 goals. All right.
That'll finish them off, sorry.
Yeah, all right. Nice and assertive, I like it. All right, no mucking around here. Yeah. Let's try this then. This is a Saturday evening game. 7:10pm in Adelaide. It's Adelaide Crows versus St Kilda. Let's hear the Adelaide song. That'll do, mate. Straight to the Saints. And that'll do there. Boys, this one's probably going to be fairly interesting because St Kilda, they're in the caretaker coach mode, and we all know what's happening with caretaker coaches. And Adelaide, man, whoa, they are copping it left, right and centre. They're getting sprays from inside and out. What do you think here, though?
It's a tough one. They both got plenty to play for. St Kilda are hanging on to eighth or seventh spot or whatever. So, I don't know. I think St Kilda, I'm just going to back St Kilda, the underdogs.
Okay. Yeah, that'll do.
I'm going to go with Adelaide. Right. Over in Adelaide, I think they've got a fair bit to play for. As you said, they've copped it front and centre. So I expect Eddie Betts to come back in and have a blinder.
Yeah, he probably will, won't he? You'd expect that, yeah. Okay.
Yeah, I tend to agree. I reckon the Crows will be too strong. But St Kilda have found a bit of form of late, so it should be another good game.
Yeah, cool.
Yeah, Adelaide, maybe the Texan might kick a few.
Yeah, you think he's got to come back out? Yeah. He's been copping a bit of flack, so he probably needs it, doesn't he? Let's come back to Melbourne, 7:25pm, MCG. This game, Melbourne versus Richmond. Let's hear Melbourne. It's a grand Thanks, mate. Straight to the Tigers. That'll do there. All right, boys. Wow. I'm just a tip, I suppose. You can... I don't know what to say. Melbourne just haven't been playing good football, and it'd probably be really hard to tip them. But
Richmond by 8 goals.
Yeah, Richmond.
Okay,
Richmond
that'll do. Them. What do you think, Ads?
Richmond or Flog them.
Yeah, Flog them, yep.
Yeah, north of 8 goals, I'd imagine.
Yeah, right. Yeah, same. Plenty. Leave it at that. Yeah. Move on again. All right, this one very quickly. MCG, 1:10pm on Sunday, August the 4th. Collingwood versus the Gold Coast Suns. Let's hear the Gold Coast Suns. No, that'll do. All right, made a mistake. Let's go the Collingwood one. Join in if you want. We'll give you a little bit of it as well.
Good old Collingwood forever. They know how to play the game. Side by side they stick together.
Very quiet.
To uphold the magpie's name. See the barrackers are shouting as all barrackers should. Oh, the premiership's a cakewalk.
People that joined in, or two of you, that was wonderful. So what do you think here, boys? Collingwood versus Gold Coast Suns. We'll go this end first because obviously we know what you boys are going to do.
Yeah, I think the Pies should take care of Gold Coast.
Yeah,
I tend to agree.
Pretty easy.
Yeah,
all right. You guys will win. It'll be all right. Okay. But don't be complacent because you know how those things can happen. Go out there and, just smash them. Let's go to this game, 3:20pm. It's at Marvel Stadium. It's Carlton versus West Coast. Let's hear the Carlton song. Thanks, mate. Straight to West Coast. All right. Now, you would normally think this could be a bit of a shoe-in, but again, caretaker coach, Carlton, what?
Three in a row.
They're playing some good football. Let them go out, just run free and play like you can. And they're playing good football. And last week was probably a better example of what they've been capable of out of the last three games. So what do you boys think here? How would you go?
Yeah, they're playing footy, Carlton, but I still think the Eagles will... probably have six people tagging Paddy Cripps.
Yeah.
keep him to 40 still, and then but Eagles will still win.
Yeah, all right.
Yeah, I think 10 weeks ago you would have said Eagles by 10 goals, but I reckon it'd be Eagles maybe by 15, 16 points.
Yeah, okay, all right. So not a huge margin, just get across the line. All right.
I think it would be interesting to see. Carlton have obviously found a bit of form, but West Coast, we played West Coast about a month ago, and they were pretty scary. So yeah, I'd say by 5 or 6 goals, West Coast.
Yeah.
I think their forward line, Kennedy, Darling.
It's a really good forward line. It really is.
Pretty good.
Yeah, and they're coming into form just at the right time of the year. They are a scary-looking unit. Ugly as well, but anyway. Let's go to this game. It's at the Gabba. It's our last one we want to talk about. It's 4:40pm. It's Brisbane Lions versus the Western Bulldogs. Let's hear the Brisbane song. We are the Thanks, mate. Brisbane. Straight to the Dogs. And that'll do there. We'll go down to the U first, Adam Treloar. What do you think? Brisbane Lions versus Western Bulldogs. Brisbane Lions, what a surprise packet those boys have been.
Yeah,
that's been an amazing year for
them.
Talking
about that before, between the four of us. Yeah, they're going really well. But again, like the St Kilda Crows game, I think the Dogs have a lot to play for. I think they're only 4 points out of making the finals, or being in the finals. So I don't know. I think, I'm going to go the Bulldogs.
Yep.
I know Brisbane are good up there, but we played them really well up there, and I know they're in fine form, but I'm going to go to the Bulldogs.
Okay, mate, good.
Yeah, I reckon it'll be closer than most people think. I wouldn't be surprised if the Dogs won, but I think if I have to have a tip, I'd tip the Lions.
Yeah, right, okay. And boys?
Yeah, I'm much the same. I wouldn't be shocked if the Doggies pinched it, but you sort of have to back Lions at the moment.
Form.
Yeah, all right. Well, wonderful, boys. Thank you very much. That was absolutely wonderful. All I want to do now is just say those games are brought to you by the Big Picture People, the experts in home cinema. 6 great locations, South Moraine, Cheltenham, Fountain Gate, Hoppers Crossing, Water Gardens and the Gold Coast. Could you please put your hands together for the boys? Thank you. Thanks, boys. Thank you very much. All right, what we want to do now, we want to get you people involved. As I told you at the start of the show, this is where the fans meet the players and the players meet the fans. We need you to get involved in the show. This is your one opportunity to actually do so. We want a contestant from each of the clubs. Someone from Collingwood, someone from Essendon, and those people need to know a fair bit about the club. Hey, this segment is called Simply the Best. You're simply the best. Better than all the rest. It's Collingwood versus Essendon, and we're going to see how you go. Out of you two gentlemen down the front, who would like to go first? He can go first. Well, he did get in first and say he can go first. So, Adam, your time to get all of these rights is right now because we want you to shine for the Essendon Football Club. Are you ready to go, my friend?
Yes.
All right, I've got 13 questions for you. We want to see how you go. Raz is ready to flip it over. He wants to get his arm going like a windmill. So, how many premierships has your club won?
16.
No, 15. Mm. Bad luck. Oh, 16. Sorry. It is 16. Yeah, it's all right. Sorry. My fault, Adam. My fault. Apologise, Adam. Adam.
Yes.
I'm sorry. All right. How many times has your team played in a losing grand final? Adam.
I'm going to say 22.
You got the second one wrong because it's 29. All right. Who is your team's captain?
Dyson Heppel.
Correct. Well done. Who wears the number 7 at your club?
Zach Merritt.
Correct. How many members does your club currently have closest to within 1,000?
85,000.
82,769. Bad luck. Where did your team finish on the ladder at the end of the home and away season last year?
We were 10th?
No, 11th. Mm. How many games did your team win last year at the end of the home and away season?
Was it 11?
No, 12. Mm. Bad luck. What year did your team last win a grand final and who did they play?
2000.
And who did they play?
Melbourne.
Correct. Well done. 1 point. How many points did you win that grand final by?
60.
Correct. 60. Who won the Norm Smith medal in that grand final?
James Heard.
Correct. For 2 points, who was your club's leading goal kicker in 2018?
The package.
It is the package. And how many goals?
30.
Correct. 2 points you got. For 4 points, who was the last Essendon player to win a Brownlow medal? What year and how many votes did they poll?
James Heard.
No, you're actually right. We're going to go with that because unfortunately they are the rules. James Heard is correct. What year and votes?
1996.
Yes.
And was it 18?
No, you got 2 points. James Heard, 1996, 21. All right. And here is your last one. Name three coaches over the last 20 years.
John Worsfold.
Yes.
James Heard.
Yes.
And Kevin Sheedy.
That'll do. Perfect. Well done. How'd you go? 11. Not bad. Actually, mate, that was pretty good considering I started off with 2 Collingwood questions. That was really good, in fact. My apologies to you for that, Adam, but you did come out unscathed. So you walked away with 11. Terry, you're up against it, mate. You've got an 11 to beat. Can Collingwood do it? We'll see how we go. All right. Let's try. I'm going to read out Collingwood questions this time.
Go for it.
All right. Here we go. How many premierships has your club won?
15.
Correct. Not bad, eh? That was all right. How many times has your team played in a losing grand final?
27.
27 is correct. Sorry, everyone. Who is your team's captain?
Pendlebury.
Scott Pendlebury, correct. Who wears the number 7 at your club?
Trelaw.
Adam Trelaw, it is. Well done. How many members does your club currently have closest to within 1,000?
I think about
85,188.
How many?
85,188. Well done. Good man. Where did your team finish on the ladder at the end of the home and away season last year?
Second.
Third.
Third. They'll run us up. Oh, home and away.
Yes, home and away. That's it. How many games did your team win last year at the end of the home and away season?
15.
Yeah, correct. Well done. What year did your team last win a grand final and who did they play?
2010.
Yeah. And who did they play?
St Kilda.
St Kilda, correct. Well done. How many points did you win that grand final by?
I think it was 63.
How many?
63 points.
No, it wasn't. It was 56. Bad luck. Who was the Collingwood player that won the Norm Smith medal in that grand final?
Pendlebury.
It was. 2 points. Who was your club's leading goal kicker in 2018?
2000. That's last year. yeah, I got that one.
Who was the person and how many goals?
The goalie.
That's correct.
I think it was 48.
Mate, congratulations. 2 points, you got it. It was Jordan Ngoi with 48 goals. This is for 3 points, player, year and votes. That's what I'm after. Who was the last Collingwood player to win a Brownlow medal? What year and how many votes did they poll?
Dane Swan, 2011.
Yes.
It was either 30 or 31. I think it was 30.
It was 34. Oh, so you got 2 points. How's he sitting? He's on 12. Mate, ooh. Here we go. And this one, name three coaches over the last 20 years.
Oh, that's Buckley, Malthouse and Shaw.
That'll do. That'll do, brother. There you go. Total score of 15. You are our winner. You are simply the best. Well done, champ. Simply the best. Not bad. Sit down just for a sec because I'll just let you know. Total score of 15, was it? And total score of?
11.
11. All right. Each answer that you gave then, you win $5. So that's not bad. So 15, you've just won yourself $75 just for coming up and doing that. And Adam, you're a champion, aren't you, mate?
Like to think so.
Yeah, there you go. You finished up with a total score of 11, which obviously means that you've won. You've won. Come on.
55.
Huh? You don't know. 55, yeah, that'll do. Well done. Gents, thanks very much for playing. Congratulations, Sandy will pick you up with some cash after the show. Thanks, boys. That was a little bit of fun. I enjoyed that. We just want to thank the Big Picture people who are our sponsors that look after us for that particular segment. What the Big Picture people are doing this year is they're actually giving us the opportunity to give away a big screen home cinema package. They're our great friends, the Big Picture people, the experts in smart home cinema. Imagine watching the 2019 AFL Grand Final on a giant 3-metre screen, complete with incredible surround sound. For your chance to win this amazing That's Good for Footy big screen home cinema package, go to thebigpicturepeople.com/goodforfooty. Fill in the entry form, go to the win section on the website, follow the links. T's and C's applies. Entry is only open to Victorian residents with thanks to the Big Picture people. Thank you very much. You guys did all right. I love it. All right, what we're going to do now, we want two contestants to partake in this particular thing, but you don't have to do anything but hold on to a paddle. All right, nice to have you, boys. The segment that you're actually going to be playing in is called I Got Game.
What is game? Who got game? Where's the game in life? Behind the game, behind the game. I got game.
So the way that this one works, boys, you guys decide who would like to go first, Collingwood or Essendon?
They can go.
All right, Collingwood can go first. What's going to happen here, boys, I'm going to actually be reading out, this is how it's going to work. I'm going to read out a particular win or loss, all right? So that'll be the first thing that I'll say. Then I'm going to give you the result, okay? Then what you have to tell me is worth a point for each one that you get right. You're going to tell me who the team was that you played, what round it was, what stadium you played at, and what day it was.
Is this from this year?
This year. All of these games will be from this year.
I'll just grab my phone out.
Yeah, call a friend, call Eddie. So what I want to do here is... No cheating. All right. What I want to do is, as I said, you guys will go first. I've got five games here I'm going to read out. I'll give you the win or a loss. I'll give you the actual result. Then you're going to tell me the rest, all right? For each one you get right, you get a point. So boys down the front, Charlton and Marcus, how are you? You both well? All right. You two are going to be playing keeping score. So which one's Charlton? You're Charlton. So Charlton, you'll be playing, obviously, because you play for Essendon and vice versa. So you'll know. Just keep score as I go along. Here goes your first one, boys. You won this game. The result was 11-12-78 to 9-10-64. Who was it against? What round was it?
Do we have a time limit?
Yeah, 30 seconds on each one. 11-12-78 to 9-10-64. And you won. Quick.
We won.
Yep.
You sure?
Yeah.
How long do we have left?
How long do you have left? Not long.
Alright, we'll go Carlton.
No. Western Bulldogs. Round 4, MCG, Friday night. Okay, here comes your next one. This is for your one, this game. 15-10-108, 10-9-69. Who did you play, what round?
Richmond round 2.
That's your answer?
No, not yet. Richmond. Port Adelaide.
Yes, it was Port Adelaide. Excellent.
Yes!
What round?
Hang on, wait, I'll point that out. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6.
We played
seven.
Them. We played them after we beat
round seven, beautiful. Six. Port Adelaide, round seven, where was it?
Marvel.
And what day was it?
It was a Saturday. Sorry, it was a Friday night.
Friday night, perfect, well done.
7:50, we would have won the game.
Excellent. 10:22. 4 points. He's off to a flyer. So he's got 4 points. So you turn over the paddle. You got the paddle down there. That's 4 points for Collingwood. All right, let's go with this one, boys.
I was excited about it.
This one was another win. 16-10-106, 13-9-87. Who did you play what round? 16-10-106, 13-9-87.
Melbourne?
No. It was Carlton. It was round eight. It was at the MCG. It was a Saturday night. You lost this game. 5-7-37 was the Collingwood score to 11-15-81.
North.
Round?
The bye was round 13. So round 14 we played the Bulldogs and we played 15. North. Round 15.
Round 15, correct. At where?
It was Marvel.
Marvel. What day?
Saturday.
Perfect. Another 4 points. Well done. Here's your last one. You won this game. 11-12-78 to 12-5-77.
Oh, the Eagles.
Beautiful. Round?
We played North in round 15.
Seven.
Then we played after North. After we lost to Hawthorn in round 16. Then we played round 17.
Round 17. Perfect. Where was it?
Friday, Optus Stadium,
perfect. Another 4 points. Finished up with a total score of what? 16. Correct me if I'm wrong, was it 12? 12. Total score of 12. Well done. Nice result, boys. Excellent. See, they said that when you said, well, go first, now you've got the advantage because now you know how it works. So, Charlton, you're going to be up here. We're going to give you exactly the same scenario. You guys are going to tell me, all right?
Let's do it.
So, here's your first one. You won this game. It was 20-10-130. So 18-14-112.
That was early. D's. Yeah, that was our first win. We beat the D's.
D's is correct. Round?
Three.
Yes.
Yep.
Where?
G.
Yes. Day?
It's a night game, not that much. Wouldn't have been a Friday.
Saturday night.
That's your answer?
You go.
No, you. Lock
yeah,
it in.
It wouldn't have been a Friday. I reckon Saturday night.
Okay. It was... No?
I don't know.
Time's up.
You go.
Friday.
It was Friday. Well done. Wouldn't be a Friday. It was a Friday.
Yeah.
All right. Here's another one. You won this game 17-10-112 to 9-11-65. You won that game. 17-10-112, 9-11-65.
Who did we beat? Well, Carlton. We beat them, right? No. Well, Brisbane early, yeah.
Brisbane too. Oh, I don't know.
You took it out. You're still on the clock.
Those two.
I didn't think we beat Brisbane that much.
Now I need your answer. Who would it be?
You take this one.
Yeah, all right, Brisbane.
Yes, it is Brisbane. Yeah. Excellent. What round?
Early.
Four?
Yeah, spot on. Where was it?
G.
Yes, yeah. And what day?
Arvo game.
Saturday,
Arvo.
Yeah, perfect. Yeah. Well done. All right. All four. Well done, boys. All right. Now, you lost this game. 10-12-72 to 11-11-77.
Swans.
Swans is correct. Round?
No idea.
Seven?
That's your answer?
No.
Sorry, I'm giving it away here.
No?
Nah, round eight.
Yes.
Yes.
Round eight it was. Where?
SCG.
Yes. Day?
That was also night.
It's a night game. Yeah. Wouldn't have been Friday. Saturday night.
Wrong. Friday night. Bad luck. Sydney round 8 SCG Friday night. You got two to go here, boys. These were both wins. Here comes your first win. It was 14-12, 96 to 11-11, 77. You won it.
No.
No, I beat them by a goal.
Yeah, that's true. Tony kicked out. Oh, was it beat? Wasn't Freo. That was close. Elimination here. Hawks?
What about Gold Coast boy?
2 points? What them? I'm going to say Hawks.
You want to say who?
Hawthorn.
Yes, you'd be correct. Round?
Oh, no idea.
No idea? No? Yeah. Pass on the rest?
No, it was later than that.
It was Hawthorn.
12?
Not sure.
No, it was round 13. It was at Marvel. It was a Friday. So just 1 point there, Cheldon. All right.
Yeah, we had a couple.
It's a Friday, James.
Yeah. And here's your last one. This is your last one for this round. And how are they going down there score-wise, Cheldon? 11.
Oh. Okay.
Here you go, boys. This is a win. You won this game. It was 12-14-86 to 12-9-81.
Who said it? It was Ruse, surely. Was it?
Yep. North Melbourne?
Yes, North Melbourne it is.
Yeah.
Round?
A couple of weeks ago.
What's that?
2 weeks ago. Well,
16 or 17?
I'm not sure. 17.
Round 17 it is. Yeah. Where was it?
Marvel.
Correct. And what day was it?
Saturday.
Saturday it was. Correct. Well done. Fantastic. Man, that was good, boys. It tests your memory, and I loved it. Thank you very much for participating in that. Charlton, how'd you go, man? Finished up with a total score of 14 and finished up with a total score of 12. Not too bad, boys. Both of you boys don't go away empty-handed because we think you're bloody both awesome. There's a signed football for you. And there is also a signed football for you. Well done, boys. Thanks very much for playing. Yeah. Leave your paddles down there. Appreciate you being part of that. That was pretty simple. I really enjoyed that. That tests your memory, that game. And you guys played along just perfectly. It's not easy to do that. I get it. We need two other contestants to actually come up here and participate in this. It's going to be a similar segment to that. All you got to do is hold on to some paddles. The lovely Sandy's going to choose. I'll introduce it while she is. It's called Who Are You? What's going to happen here? The boys nominated, you guys went first in that segment, so we'll flip it back over. Essendon can go first in this segment. You boys can take a seat. Matt. You can feel comfortable up the front there, Macca and Matt.
Let's go, Matt.
Feel free to just plonk your bums down. We're going to start off with Essendon. Now, the way that this one works, boys, what I'm going to do is I'm going to read player profiles in reverse. All right? They're player profiles in reverse. So it means basically every player at the Essendon Football Club. I'm going to be reading out their history, and then each one that I go through knocks off a point. So you're going to start at 7 points, down to 6, down to 5, down to 4, until you can guess who the player is.
Okay.
All right? That's how we're going to do this one. So we'll start with your first one. I was born on the 14th of May, 1992. Any takers? No? Next clue?
Can you guess? Endless
guess? Yeah, you can guess at all. Anytime you want to guess, you can guess.
I'm going to have one guess at it.
You can keep guessing the whole way through as I keep going down. It's just worth less. Okay. I'll ask.
Hep?
It is Hep. You've got it. All 7 points. There you go. Very good. That was nice and easy. 7 points was your first little get. Here's your second one. I was born on the 21st of February, 1990.
Zaka?
It is. David Zaharakis. Never. Another 7 points. You guys are good at birth dates. I like that. I was born on the 13th of October, 1988.
88.
Cale Hooker.
Oh, my God. He's got that as well. That's, you're already over as much as you can score. That's 21 points already. Wow. I was born on the 2nd of June, 1998.
I don't know the young kids. This one's yours.
98.
Fucking young.
3 years.
Next clue?
Yeah, next clue.
I debuted in 2017.
Andy McGrath?
It is. Well done. 6 points. That's up to 27.
Yeah.
And you know what? That's it. You've done it. 27. You've got all four. 27 points is what you finished up with. That's huge. Well done. I didn't even get anywhere through those questions. You just went on birth dates. I love it. All right, Collingwood boys, you're up. Macca, you must be feeling pretty comfortable down there. You're feeling confident the boys will get these?
Yeah,
good. All right.
On your Macca.
That's a reigning endorsement right there, boys. Let's see how you go. If I have to go past birth dates like these boys, that was wonderful. I was born on the 7th of January, 1988.
It's Pendles.
Yeah, it is. Scott Pendlebury, you got 7 points. Well done. This was meant to be hard. I was born on the 29th of June, 1990.
100%.
What do you reckon?
Can we say, is it either Howie or Steele?
No, you can just give me one. That's how this game works, just one.
Howie.
It is. Yes. Jeremy Howe. Well done, another 7 points. You're up to 14, Macca, you're killing it. I was born on the 25th of January, 1996.
23.
Who's
23?
Jordan
Gowie.
Jordan.
That's your answer?
Jordan.
No.
Okay.
All
right. Not if you're saying like
I debuted in 2015.
Hey, we didn't ask for that, so we still get 7 points.
Well, it's not Jordan Gowie.
When did you debut?
He debuted in 2015.
Brazzy debuted in 2015.
Brazzy. Brad Maynard.
No.
Ooh.
I've played 68 games of football, and so far in my career, I've kicked 61 goals.
Darcy Moore
it is. You ended up with 5 points for that one. And here's your last one, boys. I was born on the 2nd of January, 1991.
And Steel.
Rusty. Rusty it is. 7 points there. Total score? As he just doubles it all over. Was that... So, finished up with five, then it finished up with six. Six on top of... Yeah, that... You, Essendon. Essendon win. Essendon have won it. Well done. You're absolute champion. Who are you? What the boys have just won for you, Matt, the reluctant Matt who really didn't want to come up, you've just won a cheesecake. All right? That's going to get delivered to your table, which you and your lovely partner who nominated you to come up can share. All right. You're not going to go home empty-handed. I'm actually going to give you a merchandise pack, which comes with a can. It's a soft drink can holder. All right. And it's got a beanie in there and a stubby and some other things. And what I might do, I might even see if I can get you something else at the end of the show. But well done, Macca. Thanks for playing.
Macca.
Good on you, champion.
Matt.
Loved it. Well done. What's it look like, babe? Whoa. You got it. That's good for footy cake, babe. They're as rare as hen's teeth.
Yeah.
Share that when you're here later. I know Ads has got a bit of a sweet tooth, so he might come over and join you as well. Yeah, that'd be all right, wouldn't it? Yeah, excellent. All right. What I now need you to do, ladies and gentlemen, is this is the part where we just acknowledge everything that's happened tonight. I told you at the start of the show, this is where the fans meet the players and the players meet the fans. Do you guys reckon you've done that tonight?
Yeah.
Good. Because that's what we aim to do. That's all we try and do here. We're sorry that this room is not full of 460 people, but it's full of 46 fantastic people. So thanks to everyone for coming along and being part of tonight. We really appreciate it. Good of you to come out and support it. What we're going to do now, I just want to allude to the fact that if you want to come along to any of these shows, the only way you can find out about them is to go onto the That's Good for Footy Facebook page or the website. All the details are there, and you can come along and be part of the shows whenever we travel around Melbourne. It's pretty easy to find out. Get onto That's Good for Footy /events. I want to tell you about a couple of shows coming up. Essendon fans, you'll want to listen to one of them. Upcoming shows on August the 7th, we're appearing on the show will be Jason Johannesson and Josh Dunkley from the Western Bulldogs Football Club, live from Skyways Hotel Airport West. On August the 14th, appearing on the show will be Dylan Shiel and Andrew McGrath from the Essendon Football Club, live from the Hallam Hotel in Hallam. You boys are glad you're not driving down there, aren't you? Yeah. Ads goes, that's not bad, that's around the corner from me. On August the 21st, this show's just been announced today, hasn't even been put up on the Facebook page or anywhere else. It is appearing on the show will be Shane Edwards and Sydney Stack from the Richmond Football Club, live from the Club Tivoli, 291 Dandenong Road in Windsor. I'm looking forward to meeting Sydney Stack. It should be a ripper of a show. And then we've got a show coming up on August the 28th, but as I said, get onto the Facebook page to find out. I now just wanted to thank all our sponsors. Thanks to Sandy, the framing queen. Sandy does all this stuff. She frames all of this, all right? So if you've ever got any football jumpers or boots or anything that you've got that's football orientated, see the lovely Sandy and she'll look after you. You can find her on her Framing Queen Facebook page. The big picture people, I explained, an $11,000 home theatre surround sound package. Get those details off the website or off the Facebook page. Enter it, because someone's going to get it delivered to their house on August the 28th, which is, what, only 4 weeks away. The Comics Lounge, you won Best on Ground tonight. Did you ever look at everything in your envelope? You're going go-karting. You happy about that? Hope you enjoy it, Macca. Think if that's good for footy when you're pranging to the wall. Hamper World, thanks very much for their supplying of the hampers. The Cheesecake Shop, enjoy that. Is there any left? A little bit, yeah. Well done, Matt. Thank you. Burley Seacom for all the footballs. 3D Mini League for the figurines, which I'm taking back home because none of you wanted to buy it because I sell them at the shop and this lady told me so. And Auscarts, well done, because you're going go-karting. All I want to do now is just say thanks, Sam. Sam's our sound engineer. He looks after us at all the shows. He's a champion. Does a really good job. The lovely Sandy, I won't be able to get her away from talking to the football players. See, she's not even listening right now, as you can tell. But thanks to the lovely Sandy for being part of it. She looks after you all at the door and so forth and sells the raffle tickets. And lastly, ladies and gentlemen, this is the really important stuff. Thank you, Adam Trelaw and Taylor Adams from the Collingwood Football Club. They're the loveliest blokes I've had the pleasure of having on the shows before, and I'm glad you've got to see them in the same way I see them. They're real champions and they're great representatives of their club, as are these two, Michael Hurley and Horatio Fantasia from the Essendon Football Club. Really good luck, Michael. I hope that everything goes well in your rehab and you get back out in the field. I'd love to see you playing finals, mate. You're a terrific bloke and it'd be really good to see you out there for the Essendon Football Club when finals time comes around. Likewise for you, mate. I hope that everything goes well. No more soft tissue injuries. Just get out there and do your best for the Essendon Football Club. Knock on wood. There you go. It's all well and good. Good luck to Essendon. Good luck to Collingwood moving forward. Please thank the boys for one last time. This has been the That's Good for Footy panel show. My name's Damien. Thanks to everyone for coming along tonight. Thank you and good night. Cheers, guys.